call it what you want, cause she can call it what she.
And a lot of style coming off the Cavaliers bus earlier on. We'll see if that style translates to the court as they get set to do battle on the road. Welcome, everybody, to the day we've all been looking forward to. The start of a new NBA season on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan. With me tonight, Greg Anthony and Richard Jefferson. And reporting from the sidelines all game long, we've got David Aldridge. Hey, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Now, Darius Garland is drawing comparisons to another all-time Cavs point guard, four-time All-Star Mark Price. Now, Price said, I do see it. I really like his game. They come into the NBA so young now. All Darius has to do is stay, and he's going to be a star for a long time. Well, if anyone would know, Kevin, it would be him. Back to you.
You're exactly right. They're both dead-eye shooters, aren't they, David? We appreciate that report. Thank you. Here's the starting group for the Cleveland Cavaliers. The defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Mitchell is out there with Garland. And it's Okoro in at the three. And for the Raptors, Van Vliet in the backcourt. Trent Jr. to his side. The forwards are Barnes and Siakam. And it's Poeltl in at the five. And here we go. Fast break. Van Vliet's got it. And Darius Garland picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Van Vliet on the wing. Plenty of space. You know, almost every team has some kind of roster turnover in the offseason, so, Greg, this time of year can be about getting familiar with your new teammates.
There's always a feeling out process this early in the schedule. It's about finding your team's identity, figuring out how all the pieces are going to fit.
In the corner is Van Vliet, the three. Allen with the rebound. To the wing right side. Here's Okoro. Allen trying to break free. And Okoro with the basket on the assist by Allen.
It's great whenever a big knows how to handle it. Allen sharing the wealth. Jared Allen has become a cornerstone of this Cleveland Cavalier team. He plays on both sides of the ball with such intensity.
And so it's Mitchell who brings up the ball for the Cleveland Cavaliers. In deep. And there's another one for the Cavaliers.
And man, does Mitchell get buckets. And from everywhere on the floor, a versatile offensive threat.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
And it's finishes like that which have helped them build this lead here in the first half.
Siakam passes to Poeltl. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line. And talking about Jared Allen, he sure has improved his offensive numbers in recent years.
Yeah, the average in scoring just keeps going up, averaging a double-double three of the last four seasons. Impressive young center to keep your eyes on.
And the Raptors making a change here. Achua's checked in. Then for the Cavaliers, Wade, he's checked in for Jared Allen. And Caris LeVert subbed in for Okoro.
When you give Garland these looks, oh, he's going to find ways to capitalize, but I love his aggressiveness.
To the middle, here's Poeltl. Good, and Van Vliet gets the assist. Pirtle's got five.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. He'll gladly take those.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. The Raptors have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. On the wing, Barnes. And the dunk by Poeltl.
And look at Poeltl effortlessly dropping the hammer on the D.
Young's checked in for the Raptors. OG Anunoby comes in for Gary Trent. Eddie Osman, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. Ricky Rubio comes in for Garland. Van Vliet outside. And there's the pass to Anunoby. They set the pick. Young pass to Achua. Toronto gets it back with a new 14. Wade against Van Vliet. Passes to LeVert. It's rebounded by Anunoby. Over in the corner, Barnes. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Cavaliers lead by three. We'll be back shortly, live from Toronto. But a fairly even matchup after the first quarter of play. And taking a look at the Cavaliers' performance here, what do you guys see?
Well, the offense is clicking, and they seem to have seized the momentum here early on.
Credit the game plan coming in. They've identified some weaknesses, and they are exploiting them.
On the floor for Cleveland, getting going here in the second. They've got Darius Garland. Also Green out there. Okoro out there with Allen. And it's Osman in at the power forward. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there.
Jump ball called on the play.
Trent gets the bucket. Trent's got his first basket.
Guy's just ridiculous. He's just an absolute surgeon when he has the ball. This man is surgical. There is no way to slow him down when he wants to score.
Count it.
And there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
And with Darius Garland, the first All-Star game appearance was so special for him.
Yeah, playing in that 2022 game in his home arena in Cleveland. And he played for Team LeBron. That also helped. Garland has some highlight reel plays. He scored 13 points. He's pretty good coming off the bench. He's proving that he belongs with the NBA's best.
Now here's Van Vliet. Isaac Okoro missing his last shot. The shot's good.
And unafraid to challenge the heart of this defense. Van Vliet's a strong finisher for his side.
Green inside. Defended by Trent. That one goes. Count it. And we're now about a minute and a half into the second quarter. Siakam looking around. The dunk by Achua.
And the all-around game of Siakam is so adept at working the ball to open guys.
Scout Siakam with the assist.
Here's Okoro, and Okoro throws it down.
And those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
And you can feel the jolt of energy that he sent through his team. That is a huge boost in a tight game like this.
Here's Siakam. The Cavaliers making the shot. Pass to Anunoby. Front pass the arc. Still looking for his first make after that miss. He's 0 for 2. Here's Osman. No points in the game yet for him. And again, it's Cleveland. Raptors trail by five. Van Vliet up top, guarded by Garland. Achua kicks to Trent. No good on the three. For Cleveland, they've gotten four of their first five shots to fall in the second quarter. Outstanding shooting. Whistle blows, basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
The size and strength of Allen is sometimes overwhelming for defenses, even when they try to rough him up.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Some changes for Toronto. Pirtle, he's checked in for Achua. Chris Boucher comes in for Pascal Siakam. And it's Barnes in for Trent. And the Cavaliers will go with a different look here. Wade, he's checked in for Osman. Caris LeVert comes in for Isaac Okoro. Donovan Mitchell's checked in for Danny Green. And Ricky Rubio subbed in for Garland.
A pure five. Jared Allen isn't trying to shoot a bunch of threes. He bangs down low. He rebounds, protects the paint. He is a rare breed.
Van Vliet with it. And Allen picks him up defensively. Van Vliet against Allen. Now Van Vliet. Shot clock at 5. In the corner, it's Boucher. Here's Poeltl. He knocks it down, but wait a minute. The officials are getting together. They may want to review this one. And we are not going.
The previous play is under review.
Going to review the tape.
And the footage relayed to the officials from the replay center in Secaucus, I think he got it off in time. The replay leaving little doubt.
After the review, the ruling on the floor is overturned.
And the call is going to be overturned. The second look shows that he did, in fact, beat the clock.
Yeah, they're glad they're going to get those points. It wasn't too long ago that they even looked at it on the monitor. But replay's here, and it's here to stay for situations just like that.
And we've reached halftime in this one. Cavaliers on top, up 6. We'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
And thank you for joining us as, with two quarters in the books, it's looking good for the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Man, this is just beautiful basketball, poetry in motion. I mean, I think if they stay efficient, Ernie, in the second half, they'll pull away.
And now you have me wondering about poetry. Do you think Walt Whitman had a jump shot?
Maya Angelou did.
And let's focus now on the two opposing guys who were battling in the first half. There were sparks out there.
Two guys clearly battling for the spot, both putting on a show. You just hope it doesn't become an all-hero ball.
Yeah, it's the scoreboard that decides the real winner in the end. That's pretty profound on my part, don't you think?
Yes, it does.
That is more than enough of us. Let's send you back to the game, Kevin Harlan and crew, with the second half.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. A fantastic game from Jakob Poeltl in this one.
What a welcome surprise that first half went above and beyond his usual scoring output.
And I like that they had the confidence in him to keep calling his number.
The forwards are Barnes and Siakam. Van Vliet in the backcourt. Trent Jr. to his side. And it's Poeltl in at the center position. That's Nick Nurse's 5 as we get into the second half. Garland with the bucket. How did you react, Richard, to the changes and rules in 2021, specifically those banning non-basketball moves?
I loved it because the game has gone so far offensively that it put the defenders in such a bad spot. And so now that you're allowing for the defenders to actually play defense now, I think it's great for the game.
And instead of right tricking your way to the free throw line.
Yeah, because they were using that it's not a foul, it's what they call. And let's turn what they call into actual fouls. So the referees cleaned it up perfectly.
Raptors trail by 5. And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
That's his first personal foul.
The Raptors are only a few years removed from its championship in 2019. Boy, a lot has changed since then.
So both teams changing it up here. Now, here's Trent. Not going to go that time. Good D by Mitchell. And it's Mitchell with the ball for Cleveland. A lot of change. Toronto is without some of the key pieces from that title team, and it wasn't that long ago. But, Greg, they haven't had to go through a full rebuild. There are some remaining parts.
Listen, the talent they have is still undeniable, and they've got a good mix of young up-and-comers and players in the prime of their career.
Got that bucket in no time at all. Mobley's got his second basket of the game.
The nice touch from the interior. Mobley looks very comfortable shooting from there.
And that was another look at the fantastic Mobile One drive that happened a moment ago.
And that's the kind of bucket they needed. Close game in the second half. Great finish on that one.
Uses both hands to slam it down.
Oh, an aggressive move and finish.
fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. Stolen by Van Vliet. And here we go. Fast break. Van Vliet's got it. Mobley with the block.
Already a stellar defender. Mobley proving he can be relied on to anchor for this team.
Plays it up and banks it in. Mobley's got his third bucket of the night.
And you gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind it out game.
Van Vliet finds Barnes. Pass to Trent. He's looking for Siakam and finds him. It's stolen by Allen.
And no need to rush this. Let the clock run down.
Yeah, and you don't have to be quick. You just have to be deliberate.
That was just a perfect possession, getting it in tight for the high percentage shot.
Raptors trail by six. Van Vliet looking around. And again, no good by Toronto. Allen outside. And no luck with that time on the buzzer beater. And we've reached the end of the third. Cavaliers lead by six. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. The Cavaliers leading by six. So on the floor for Cleveland. Mitchell is out there with Ricky Rubio. Then it's Evan Mobley. Then there's Caris LeVert. And it's Wade in at the four. What do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Cavaliers? Okoro's checked in for Cleveland.
Isaac Okoro.
Van Vliet with it. The pass to Pirtle. He takes it in, and the dunk by Pirtle.
You gotta respect Pirtle's aggressiveness, putting it on the floor and getting the job done on the drive.
Here's LeVert, and he makes good on the layup. LeVert's got his first basket of the night.
And despite the size disadvantage, attacking the heart of that defense.
Really unfazed. Throw his height right out the window.
Van Vliet can't get it to go.
Questionable shot selection on that three. Not really helping as they try and narrow the deficit.
Here's Mobley. Plays it up and in on the nice Mobley reverse.
Look, even against contact, even if you try and be physical with the Mobley, this man just stays strong and gets it to go.
Van Vliet kicks to Boucher. The Raptors rebound. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
That's his first personal foul. Second team foul. At the line for your Raptors.
He drops the first one, and that turns the lead to six.
And Pirtle is a massive guy, someone that uses his height exceptionally well to get high-quality looks at the bucket.
Young's checked in for Chris Boucher.
The lead's not looking as comfortable after those free throws. Nice job.
Rubio right side. .135 left in the fourth. Pirtle with the steal. Pass break. Here come the Raptors. Barnes got the ball. Pull-up jumper. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Wade outside. LeVert in the corner. No good there. Now Toronto takes it the other way. Barnes with it. Guarded now by Okoro. It drops. And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Well, you just love seeing a player with absolutely no fear.
He knew what they needed here and was determined to deliver.
Some changes for Toronto. Pascal Siakam comes in for Young, and Trent subs in for Ananobi. And the latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Hey, Kevin. During that last break, I heard J.B. Bickerstaff talking with his team. This game is obviously close, could go either way, and he wanted to make sure that his guys were all on the same page and were all staying with the game plan in order to close this one out. Kevin?
Thanks, David. And here is Siakam. Van Vliet outside. Kept alive. Here's Poeltl. Money!
In these types of situations, this team turns to Poeltl. He is more than ready for any challenge that comes his way.
Now, here's Okoro.
Can't afford any wasted possessions down the stretch.
Pretty much, they have to be perfect the rest of the way. That puts tremendous pressure on your offense.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
And it's tied up with that one.
In a tight game, he is exactly who he wanted at the line.
And so Garland will bring it up for the Cleveland Cavaliers. Count it!
I love seeing young players like Garland stepping up to the challenge and being the guy for their team.
And the Raptors call time here. They're down by two. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, your thoughts?
Big chance here to tie it with a bucket.
And you also have to wonder if they'll try for a three. But they'll probably try for a two. But if something opens up outside, I doubt that they will hesitate to take it.
Here's Siakam. Yes!
And delivering in the clutch. Siakam with zero fear, wanting the ball when it matters most.
Here's Mitchell. Missed! And Darius Garland picks up the foul. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two. He knocks down the clutch free throw.
And Siakam wants to be the guy for this team, especially in these types of high-pressure situations.
Yeah, free throws put them in an excellent position to win this thing now. It's all in the hands of the D.
Timeout called Cleveland. They're trailing by two. 5 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
I don't think they should be greedy here and think about a triple. With this much time left, I'd attack the basket, get a high percentage shot in tight, and take my chances in overtime.
Here's Mitchell. Oh, wow, a huge basket to tie the game.
Big time play there from Mitchell. Remember, he's been the go-to guy since his rookie year.
And regulation now complete. We will go to overtime. We'll be back shortly, live from Toronto. Glad to have you with us as we get going in overtime. Neither team giving an inch in this one.
Here we go.
And Van Vliet out there with Ananobi. Then there's Scotty Barnes. And then there's Precious Achiuwa. And it's Poeltl in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Here's Mobley. Oh, yes, he did. Five up and five down for him so far. Mobley's gone a perfect 5 for 5 from the field. Van Vliet wide open from outside off the mark.
This is the definition of forcing it. He's trying to get himself going, but taking tough shots just won't do it.
Allen buries it down low. And the Cavaliers lead by 4.
So much reach. Allen using that wingspan to his advantage.
Van Vliet against Garland. They double-team Van Vliet. And too much time in the lane, they get called for the 3-second violation. And the Cavaliers call time here. They lead by 4. We've got 1:13 left to play in the first overtime. Danny Green, he's checked in for Donovan Mitchell. Garland against Van Vliet. Garland with the bucket.
You see the body control that Garland has, takes on the defender, gets hit, adjusts, and finishes. It's just a work of art.
Toronto calls timeout. They trail by six. We've got 108 left in overtime. Trent's checked in for OG Anunoby. And the Raptors with the ball. They trail by six. A dunk by Achiuwa.
And great find by VanVleet. He's in control of this offense and generally makes good decisions.
Here's Allen, and it's Allen slamming it down.
And although an undersized center, more than making up for it with some serious hops. And not sure they've got enough time to save themselves.
And if I were them, I'd start thinking about where I'm going to get food after the game, because this one looks a bit out of reach.
And when Poeltl gets into a groove, he demands the ball. He's incredibly dangerous when he has the hot hand.
And that's an intentional foul. The Raptors making a switch here. Siakam's checked in. Here's Garland. Stolen by VanVleet. Over in the corner, Barnes launches a three. Mobley with the rebound. And so they choose to intentionally foul.
Gary Trent Jr. That is first personal foul.
So the first one drops, and that puts them up by five.
One look at Evan Mobley, and you can see he is built for this position. The height, the length, he's got all the physical gifts that a power forward could ask for.
Perfectly done at the strike there. That brings their lead up to an even more comfortable level.
VanVleet finds Siakam. The shot will not fall. Cavaliers go the other way with it. And an intentional foul right there.
That is first personal foul. 13
down. Good on the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
Jared Allen at the line for two.
So it gets them both, and it's an 8-point game. Not sure the miracle Greg is on hand here tonight for them.
Well, they need one, but gonna play it until the final whistle.
And so it's Mobley with it. He'll bring it up for the Cleveland Cavaliers. They lead by eight. That's the biggest of the game.
I love the intensity from Mobley going right up inside, not avoiding the contact.
14 down.
Shooting. He hits the first one, and that will put them up by nine.
Taking two shots.
And both free throws good for Mobley.
Making no mistakes and putting some extra nails in the coffin right here. That'll pretty much do it.
Anunoby has the open look. And again, Toronto no luck. So we see the Cavaliers taking the win here. And they had some nervous moments down the stretch, but things finally came together for them in overtime.
Yeah, probably didn't anticipate that this one would be that close down the wire. But give them credit, they were able to regroup in that overtime. And this win has to feel satisfying.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. Danny, a strong defensive effort both individually and team. Now, how comfortable are you at that end of the floor now, knowing that you can make things tough on the opposition?
Well, we want to make them take tough shots. We're not comfortable at any point defensively, but we got to continue to be active and be aggressive and get our hands on loose balls.
Been the mark of the Spurs for a long time, Danny. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. That concludes the first game of the NBA season. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. As New Balance presents our player of the game, Evan Mobley.